I'm Dr. Sri, I'm a board certified family medicine, sports medicine doctor. In this video, I'm going to discuss about weight loss injections. So basically the commonly prescribed weight loss injections such as the Saxenda, or the Ozempic, or the Mounjaro, or the Zepbound. So I'm going to talk about how these injections work for weight loss. I'm going to talk about the risk and benefits of these injections. And I'm going to share my advice on how to make the most out of these medications. So without further ado, let's get started. So in the last few years, I've prescribed these injections for many of my patients. For some of my patients, it has helped a lot. For some patients, it actually did not help at all. For some patients, it actually caused more harm. So in the next few minutes, we're going to discuss about these injections, the complexities and the intricacies of these injections, so that you can have a better understanding to make an informed decision. So now first, let us understand how weight loss works. While it might sound simple, the truth is that burning more calories than you consume is still key for weight loss. However, not all calories are the same. So wait, what did I mean when I said all calories are not the same? So basically, some calories can actually help with weight loss easily, whereas some calories actually help with weight gain more easily. For instance, nuts are high in calories, but studies have shown that overconsumption of nuts does not lead to weight gain. Maybe they promote the growth of good bacteria in your gut, and thereby it in turn increases your metabolism and thereby help burn more calories in the long run. Similarly, dietary protein can increase lean body mass and indirectly help burn more calories. Vegetables are low in calories, but they also serve as food for your gut bacteria, thereby helps you to lose weight. So basically, in simple terms, where one can lose weight by burning more calories than you consume, still, there are a lot of complexities associated with that. So to lose 1 pound of body weight, you need to create a calorie deficit of around 3,500 calories. Also keep in mind that as you lose weight, your calorie requirement changes so that you'll need to gradually burn more calories than you consume. So why is weight loss so challenging? And the reason is because maintaining a calorie deficit every day is really hard. So there are many factors that comes into play. For example, I went to Olive Garden yesterday for a meeting, and my plan was not to eat a certain food, but eventually I did. And I'm pretty much like distracted during the meeting, and I eat more calories than what I intend to. And when I came out of the Olive Garden, I've already consumed an extra 1,000 calories for the day. Thankfully, I was able to play tennis that day, so I was able to burn almost like 700 calories by playing tennis for almost 90 minutes. So let us say if I was not able to play tennis that day, that was an excess of 1,000 calories, even though it was just from one meal that day. So let us say if I do the same thing 3 times in a row during the week, I've already gained almost 1 pound. Let us give you another example. So let us say I fall sick. So usually I take almost like 10,000 steps a day. But let us say if I fall sick and I've taken only 1,000 steps that particular day, then I've spent almost 600 to 700 calories less throughout the day. And thereby, if I keep doing this again and again, I'll start to gain weight. As you can see, there are many factors that goes in play. So maintaining a calorie deficit every day is really hard. So as you can see, in order to make weight loss a success, the most significant factor to manage is our appetite. One of the hormones that regulates our appetite is called as a GLP-1. It makes us feel full and also increases insulin secretion based on our blood sugar levels. A significant breakthrough is the development of a GLP-1 mimic injection, and it was initially approved for the treatment of diabetes. As you can see, it helps with weight loss, but it also helps with insulin secretion dependent on one's blood sugar. But because the weight loss was a major side effect from this diabetes medication, this medication eventually got approved for the treatment of obesity. Now the question is that, do these injections really work? And the answer is yes. I've had many patients in my practice who have successfully lost a lot of weight using these injections, and multiple studies also support this positive finding. So for instance, in the step 1 trial study, they compared patients using semaglutide injections, which basically comes as either Ozempic or Wegovy, and then they compared that to lifestyle interventions. And they found that the combination of injections and lifestyle changes resulted in an average 15% weight loss, almost in 1 year, compared to just 3% with lifestyle changes alone. However, I would argue that with lifestyle interventions, you can get more than 3%. For example, a study where participants had weekly check-ins and weekly education, they resulted in almost 10% weight loss and not 3% weight loss with lifestyle interventions alone. How in reality, I'm not calling my patient every week or I'm not providing a weekly education. So I think 3% might be actually a true a weight loss from a lifestyle intervention. But still, based on the study that I showed you right now, with aggressive lifestyle intervention, so if you're motivated, a person can easily achieve 10% weight loss just through lifestyle intervention alone. So if these injections work really well, why not prescribe them to everyone who's suffering from weight problems? The reason is because there are a lot of issues that comes from using these injections. So some patients experience side effects such as nausea and vomiting, and for some, the medicine is completely intolerable. Additionally, there are no long-term studies, making it difficult to predict potential long-term issues. Another biggest challenge that my patients face is that most of the insurance companies do not cover these weight loss injections, and they can be really expensive. Now let us consider a scenario in where I prescribed this weight loss injection to one of my patients, and at the end of 1 year mark, they have lost a lot of weight, and now they stopped using this injection. Can they maintain the weight loss? Based on studies, most people tend to regain the weight back. So according to the study, the average weight loss once a person stops taking injection decreases from 15% to around 5%. While there is still some benefit compared to not using the injection, it is clear that the weight loss is not as significant as the initial 15% was. So the conclusion from these studies are that the patient has to use these injections indefinitely. Yes, great conclusion for a pharmaceutical company to make more money, but that's not going to benefit my patients. Some of my patients have been not using these injections because they are out of stock. Some are patients where the insurance companies stopped approving this injection and thereby they're not able to afford the weight loss injections. Again, it's almost like they tasted weight loss, they were happy, and now they again regained all the weight back. And some of my patients have also gone to depression because of these things. So another biggest concern that we have is that people who use weight loss injections, sometimes it curbs their appetite completely. Thereby, they start to starve. When they starve, the body starts eating up the muscle tissue for energy. So thereby, they start to lose a lot of lean body mass. With any weight loss intervention, whether you use weight loss injection or not, you will end up losing a little bit of lean body mass. But when it happens excessively, that is a concern. And that's what some of the studies show, that people start to lose more than around 25 to 40% of lean body mass as they continue to lose weight. Again, when you start losing lean body mass, it becomes easier to regain the weight back because you have less muscle mass to start with. And the biggest reason is that their quality of their diet likely remains the same as before, which actually led to weight gain, with the only difference being that is that they're now consuming fewer calories. The studies also show that most people do not exercise and they rely solely on the injection for weight loss. But the question is, can exercise alone can lead to weight loss? And the answer is yes and no. The studies indicate that people need to engage in approximately 250 to 400 minutes of exercise per week in order to achieve some sort of a clinically significant weight loss. However, think about this. This is going to be really challenging for individuals who are already dealing with obesity. So with all these concerns, why do I prescribe weight loss injections then? And the answer is that it can be a lifesaver for many patients. For example, I had a patient who had uncontrolled diabetes with an A1C of almost 12.2. And he was suffering from obesity. We started him on weight loss injection. And now after 6 months, he has lost almost 30 pounds and his A1C is almost 7.1. He's leading a more physically active lifestyle. And as you can see, his diabetes got well controlled and thereby I was able to basically decrease the complications associated with diabetes. I had another patient who had bone on bone knee osteoarthritis and he was suffering from so much pain. He was not even able to take almost like 10 steps without pain. Started him on weight loss injections. In the last 1 year, he's lost 60 pounds and now he's able to walk without much pain in spite of bone on bone knee osteoarthritis. Again, these examples is just to highlight that how weight loss injections can be a lifesaver for many patients. But here's a catch. I just don't prescribe injections and not do nothing. I try to make sure that we create habits for the next 1 year. So this way, when we stop the injections, the habits can eventually help them to sustain the weight loss or to help them continue losing weight. See, when a person is suffering from obesity and experiencing issues like knee pain, exercising for 300 to 400 minutes per week is not feasible for them. The time is limited. The clock is ticking. it's important to take action to help them lose weight. A weight loss injection can help them with weight loss, and I can focus on helping them gradually introduce exercise over time, maybe even starting with just around like 30 minutes per week. See, my goal is to get the patient to exercise 300 minutes per week by the end of 1 year. But initially, probably they cannot do 300 minutes per week. So we slowly progress, and as they continue to lose weight, it becomes easier for them to meet those goals of increasing the exercise duration. So for the next few minutes, I'm going to share the most important steps that I discuss with my patients before I prescribe the weight loss injections. So my aim is to help them cultivate these habits while they're on the injection. So make sure that you grab a pen and paper handy so that you can also start to write down your realistic goals. Step one, calculate your calories. That would help us to create a calorie deficit so that we can lose 1% of body weight per week. In order to do this, you can simply search for NIH calculator on Google. So type in NIH calculator on Google, and once you go to the website, you enter your relevant information. For example, I'm going to use an example of a person who's weighing 250 pounds and he's 6 feet tall. So I'm going to input these numbers. I'm going to choose light activity as their activity level, and I'm going to select light for their leisure time physical activity. It is best to start slowly, and if you start to lose too much of weight right away, then you can always adjust your calorie intake later. It is generally safe to aim for a weight loss of around 1% of your body weight per week. In this case, with a starting weight of 250 pounds, it would be safe to aim for a 2-pound weight loss per week. If your goal weight is around 200 pounds, it may take around 6 months to achieve this. After plugging in these numbers, you should aim for a daily calorie intake of around 1,800 calories. Now let us create a plan for the number of calories that you should aim to consume each day. In this case, we're going to use an example of 1,800 calories. Make sure that you include enough protein in your diet, aiming for around 1 to 1.5 gram per kilogram of your body weight. Studies have shown that increasing your protein intake is important to preserve lean body mass. So for non-vegetarians, here's a sample meal plan. Please pause the video in order to take a look. For vegetarians or those who prefer plant-based proteins, here's a sample 1,800 calorie meal plan with approximately 120 grams of protein per day. Please pause the video to take a look at it. So please ensure that you're getting enough fruits and vegetables in your diet. The ultimate goal is to aim for at least 5 to 7 cups of vegetables per day and 2 to 3 cups of fruits per day. So with vegetables and fruits, I usually don't restrict a lot. If you want to eat more, then feel free to do so. Remember, vegetables and fruits, they can feed the good bacteria in your gut, and thereby it can also indirectly promote weight loss too. So for vegetables, aim to have a variety of types and colors. This can include leafy greens like spinach or kale, cruciferous vegetables like broccoli or cauliflower, and colorful veggies like peppers or carrots. You can enjoy them in salads, stir fries, soups, or as a side dish with your meals. For fruits, choose a mix of different types such as berries, citrus fruits, apples, bananas, or melons. You can have them as a snack or blend them into smoothies or add them to your oatmeal or yogurt. When it comes to exercise, there is no pressure to start exercise at 250 to 400 minutes per week. You can start very slow. So I would say like maybe even start with 3 to 5 minutes of walking, and slowly as a week goes by, aim to increase by maybe 2 minutes every week, and thereby the focus would be to aim for 30 minutes every day in a period of like 3 to 6 months or so. It's important to make sure that you engage in strength training in order to preserve lean body mass. You can start with simple exercises like wall push-ups or sit to stand movements on a high chair or using resistance machines at the gym. If you don't have access to a gym, I have a good news for you. I've got a home strength training program that is designed for beginners that will gradually progress from beginner exercises all the way to challenging exercises. So focus on mastering these habits every day. Keep track of your progress by journaling your smaller achievements along the way. By the end of 1 year, not only will you have lost weight, but you'll also have developed sustainable habits that won't require continued reliance on these weight loss injections. I hope this video is helpful. If you found this video helpful, can you do me a small favor? Can you please make sure that you hit the like button so that this video can reach more people? And if you have any questions or comments, please post in the comment box below. If you want to get started with a home strength training program for absolute beginners, then check out this video here. And I'll see you in my next video. Until then, goodbye.